Hello there, everyone. This is Draco Dustlinger, and welcome to my first how-to video with the how to handle the thief. In this video, I'm going to show you three of the most basic thief builds you will encounter and a basic understanding on how to counter them. Thanks to Marcus for helping me get the footage, and yeah, let's get it started. I'll go over them some of the skills. The first encounter is going to be the Dagger Thief full burst. It's the stealth backstab combo. Let's have a look at some of the skills. We got the Cloak and Dagger. It's a step that will grant them stealth when they use it, and it's a core ability in many of their builds. It looked like this. He hit you and you gain stealth. Then we got the Shadow Refugee. It's a large area stealth they have. When they throw it down, it will look like this, and you can counter it by just pushing them out with a skill like that. Heartseeker, it's the spam skill. It's this 2-2-2-2. The less life you have, the more damage it will deal to you, and it's a leap finisher, and it looks like this, and they often spam it like that. Got the Basilisk Venom. It will stun you, and they will often use it in their opener combo. The opener combo looks like this. They will steal, they will Cloak and Dagger, and then they will backstab you. The steal will teleport them to them, and it looks like this in slow motion, that he teleports with steel, he Cloak and Dagger, and he backstab, and you will got hit by the Basilisk Venom as well. Okay, what to do when they jump you? You need to keep running. You need to play defensive. You need to change direction when they stealth to avoid the backstab. When they stealth, you need to gain ground and recover as well. And when you get an opening, unleash everything you have on them. It's the basic on almost all thief builds. I'll show it here. I counter his opener with the throw mine. I then pluck his over Heartseeker spam while I start running. I start to heal up and get my defense ready, and when I got a decent health pull again, I start attacking with the prayer bar and put some conditions on him. I then start running again because my conditions will deal damage while I'm running. As you can see, I keep running and I throw a cripple on him so he couldn't get behind me and do a backstep because he was crippled. I use the throw mine again to gain control over the fight and put conditions on him. And I just keep putting conditions and then flee. Conditions flee. It's a matter about always kiting. When he jumps his Shadow Refugee, I recover as well, and he goes. He jumps me again. I use the Net Turret stun this time to avoid the opener. He still bursts me a lot, so I start running away. As you see, I try to stay away from him and put confusion on him. And I just keep kiting and try not to be in melee with him because I'm so low health, but I keep my mobility and slowly stack up my defense while I try to control him. The Net Turret and my elite skills keep him in check most of the time, and throwing down cripples will help a lot as well. As you see, my health pool is slowly getting higher and higher, and now I'm full health, and I start put pressure on him because I outlasted his burst. By playing defensive, I regain control over the fight, and now he's pretty much doomed because I can keep applying conditions on him and running around. And that's where the Net Turret is really awesome, because it grants you a lot of control. The easy counter is the Stunbreaker, because you can dodge the initial burst and then you can just start applying pressure from the go. As you see, he will drop really fast because they have low defense and you just avoid the burst, and yeah, he's already down. So yeah, that's how easy it can be done. The World vs. World Roaming Thief build, or more defensive classic Dagger Thief build. It got about the same counters as the classic build, but it got a better defense and less burst and more condition removal. Watch out for Thief Guild and his buddies. But the way you fight it is pretty much the same. As you see, he goes on here, and I throw down a mine to avoid his steel combo, and I slowly apply pressure to him. I pop a pluck, but that was necessary because he was using his elite skill. They're really annoying, the thief. They will blind you and they'll pull you like this while they do a bit of damage. But as you see, I keep kiting. I have Perma Swiftness, he don't. I throw knockbacks behind me, cripples behind me, and I try to get some conditions on him. I got a prayer bar and burning there, but he removed it. Again, I wasted my mind there. I thought he would go on me, but he popped a Shadow Refugee. So while he's stealth, I used the time with medkit to take all my buffs and medbacks, and then I start kiting again when he jumps me. It's slowly taking him down while he tries avoiding my attacks with stealth and open up with his burst. But as you can see, I just keep running and try avoid having my back to him, so I won't get hit with his backstab. It's actually quite easy when you just keep running. I just keep doing the same actually. It's quite simple. I never have a problem with these kind of thieves. I then know he's going to jump me, and I do this nice combo where I put down the confusion bomb and know he will jump to me and swap to my prey bar to make 10 stacks of confusion and then pop out into the gun and give him 12 stacks, and he's down now because he can't click anything that will kill him. So yeah, that's how we do that. The Wild Bill Thief. I recommend pause the video so you can read the basics how-to that I'm going to cover. The combo they do, it's the same combo all the time. It's very predictable. They will cloak and dagger, and then they will sneak attack you for bleeding stacks. It looks like this. They will try get into melee, cloak and dagger, then wait a time, then unleash with this sneak attack. So yeah, that's it. Okay, play defensive when you meet them. He start pulling out his elite skill. So I'm in a pressed situation to begin with. I need to play very defensive and avoid his cloak and dagger combo, so I do that by dodging every time he gets into melee with me and trap block. He then immobilize me, and I'm stuck and I can't do anything but take the burst. So I drop down my elite skill to get some recovery up. His elite skill is over now, but my elite skill is up. So I got the upper hand even when I'm on low health, because I can lock him down with the combo of the two net turrets. As you see, he throws down that gunk of goo. And when he shoots through it, there will be confusion stacks on you, so you really need to block or dodge that one. You see, I keep him immobilized right now, and I just try put up some conditions on him while I recover my health, and slowly take him down. I then try pull him, but dodge. He dodges it, so I blind him to avoid his cloak and dagger, and I got him locked down again with the immobilized. They're really weak when they can't get their stealth, and because that's the only defense that regain health there. So keep them locked down. So yeah. There was another encounter where you're stuck with a Stunbreaker. Again, I try avoid his cloak and dagger, I plug it there so he wastes his initiative. And then I dodge another cloak and dagger, and I try put up some conditions on him. I got a burning there. He then stealth, and I know the burst is coming. And I didn't avoid that confusion combo he does. So I got 5 stacks of confusion, so I just try kites while I wait it out. I'm really on low health now, so I decide I'm going to throw down my big old bomb and try put some pressure on him while he's knocked back, but I really can't get to hit him proper. So I scatter a bit away from him and throw down Elixir R for self rest. And as you see, I drop, but I get up again, and now I got no conditions on me, and I get an opener with the magnet and a prey bar on him, and that's pretty much game over for him. I got too many conditions on him, so I start applying my pressure on him again, and down he goes. So yeah, defensive play and attack when I get an
okay,
opener.
Okay guys, that's it. That's the first how-to video, and I of course would love some feedback what to do different, what you guys need more of to better understand how to counter that thief. Yeah, to sum it up, no matter what build you're using, and no matter what build the thief are using, the basic way to handle them is to keep running. You need to be mobile. You need to use the time you can't see them to heal up and gain ground, put down defenses, and the hardest part about them, no matter what build they are, is to survive the initial burst. Any good build should have some sort of tool, be it a Stunbreaker, be it enough defensive stats or access to protection or the likes of that, to survive the burst. And when you survive the burst, it's all about getting your health up running again. And then when you feel ready, when your defense is ready, it's time to strike whenever you can get an opening. And it's really easy to put them down, in my opinion, because when they are low, when they are open, you can so easily burst them. They got no defense, most of them. So yeah, that is the thief. And I really hope you guys can use this, because it's one of the classes beside the Mesmer most people have trouble with. And I think it's a shame engineers feel they have trouble with the thief, because it's really easy for us, and mostly because most of them run melee builds. So yeah, guys, until next time, and yeah, please come with feedback. But have fun, guys.